Okay, everyone. So now we are going to create the report using the crystal reports. We know that crystal report is used for creating the reports. And here we can create the pie chart bar graph from our database. That means .NET application should be connected with the database. So our step number one, that creating the database. So we are working on MS Access, going on the blank database. Then afterward, providing the name of database. Let's say DB. Then afterward, we are going and providing the path. We are going on desktop, saving the database on desktop, and we are making it compatible with the previous versions. Then afterward, press OK, then create the database. Now, here we are having the table. Right click on that, provide its design. Let us suppose that this is the employee table. Then afterward, we are pressing OK. And here we are, let's say, providing the employee ID. So this is our first field, E underscore ID. Now I am making it number. Afterward, we are providing, let's say, employee name. So this is E name. And we want that that should be the short text. Now we want that employee salary. So here what we are doing, and we want that this should also be number. So here we have taken employee ID, employee name, and employee salary. Now afterward, we are going to open the table. It is asking us to save. So save it. Yes. And afterward, we are providing, let's say, some employee, let's say Ankit. And afterward, we are providing the salary. Let's say we are providing 10,000. And afterward, let's say we are going on some other name, let's say Verma. Then we are providing the salary, let's say 20,000. And afterward, we are going on some other name. Now it is saying us that you are having the duplicate values available here in the index primary key. So click on OK. And you can see that in the primary key, this employee ID is the primary key where we have not given any value. So we are crossing it and we are providing here the value. This is 2. Let's say this is 1 because both cannot be 0. So that's why it was the error which was resolved. Now let's suppose that we are having some other employee which is AV, and here we are giving the 3. This is the primary key. Now let's say the salary is 30,000. So here we have given the salary. Now afterward, what we are doing, we are saving it. Then we are crossing it. So database is created. Now the second part. Now here we are going on the file, on the new project. On the VB.NET, which is Visual Basic, we are directly going on the reporting. Here we don't want any type of text box button or any kind of data grid view. We don't want. We simply want the report from the database. So here we are click on reporting. Then afterward, crystal report application. Here you can provide the name. Let's say you can provide simply CR. That is for crystal report. It is totally up to you which name you provide. Then press OK. Now you can see that in front of you, we are having crystal report gallery, where we are having the option create a new crystal report document. If you want to start with fresh, click on fresh. If you are having the existing, so from the existing, or if you want to create from the report wizard, then click on this. We want the report wizard. We will go step by step for creating the report. Now here it is saying that choose an expert. It is a standard. If you are having some graph, pie chart, or cross tab, if you want some kind of table, then mail, if you want to mail that. So according to your choice, you can take that. Let us suppose I am opting the standard for some chart or something. Click on OK. Now here you can see that already there is connection available in my connections. That means already your database is there. So that means this is database 3. But database 3 we have not created. That means it's some previous database. So right click, remove that. We don't want this. So here in my connections, you can see no item is found. Now we are going here, create new connection. Here it is saying that access or Excel. So we know that this is the Access database. So click on that. Now here it is saying that database name. So you have to click on there. Then on the desktop, you going to find the database DB, which we have created. Click on that and click on open. So here you can see that this is the database path which we have taken, and the database name also, which is DB, and it is the type is Access. So you can opt any database of your choice. You can take Excel, HTML, Lotus, or any other database of your choice. You can take that. I'm taking the Access right now. Afterward, if you want a secure logon, means you're having some user ID password, so provide it. Otherwise, not an option. Then afterward, we are going to make it up and click on the finish. So here you can see that we are having the access connection available. And here you can see that this is DB, MDB, which is the database we have connected. And here is the employee. This is the employee table which we have created. Now you can see that selected table. If you want one table or more table, so for that you are having the option. This arrow means taking from left hand side to right hand side, one option. And double arrow means all the tables will be coming here on the right. So only one is there because we have selected only one table. So click on that. Now it is going on the right. That means this will be considered for making the report. Now you can see that there is a back option available. If by mistake you have make it here, then you can click there, it will come back. So again, we are doing employee, clicking here. So the selected tables is coming on right hand side. So this is the selected table. Click on next. Now it is saying that these are the available fields in your employee table. We know that in the employee table, we are having employee ID, employee name and salary. What field you want to display? Again, if you click on all fields will come. If you're clicking back, all fields will go. If you are going with one by one, you can also go. So that is depend upon you that how you are proceeding. Again, going back, all are going. Again, all are coming here. I want all the fields. That's why I have taken them. Then afterward, clicking next. Now here it is saying that these are the report fields which we have chosen in the previous. Now, this is the employee table. Group by, to whom you want to group by? I want that select all, automatically they will be grouped by. Means first grouping is on employee ID, then name, then salary. So first we are taking on the employee ID. Now, so afterward we are clicking on next. Now here we can see that these are the report fields which we have selected and these are the employee table fields. Here it is saying that sum, that means it is automatically calculating the sum also. So for that you are clicking on next. Now here it is saying that group that will be sorted, means from employee ID it will be sorted. If you want somebody else, you can take that. So this is the order. We have taken the employee ID. What kind of group ordering would you like? Bottom five, top five. So depending upon that, we are taking top five, sum of employee ID. Then afterward click on next. It is asking us that what you want, no chart, you want a bar chart, you want a line chart or pie chart. So depending upon that, chart will be given to you. Now we are making the sum, then on the ordering we have given then the summary. So here we are opting for the, let's say, bar chart. Afterward we are clicking on next. Again it is saying that these are the reporting fields. You can select the reporting fields you want, ID, name, salary. And afterward is any value, means if you are going to provide some kind of condition, you can provide it here. Now afterward, next. Here it is saying that which type of report style you want. Available styles are standard, means a standard style. Leading break, you can see that there are some kind of changes which is going on. Trailing break. And afterward, you are putting the table format. Drop table or leading break with exclusive, trailing break with exclusive. You want a shading. You want red blue or you want the maroon. So let's say we are taking the red blue. Then afterward click on finish. So we can see that here some kind of report is generated from our database. Here there are multiple options which are present, that it is having the page header, then afterward group header, section header. So these are all things which are available. So this is how we can create the report from our database. So depending upon our choice, we can design the report. So that is all about creating the crystal report from database.